Welcome back to the series Know Your Vaccines. Today, we will talk about COVID vaccines licensed for use in India. Three vaccines have been licensed for use so far: Covaxin, Covishield and Sputnik. And there have been lot of queries around these. Let's learn 10 important facts about these. Are the vaccines same? Simple answer is no. Let's do a quick fact check about each. Covaxin is India's indigenous vaccine developed by Bharat Biotech in collaboration with ICMR. It's a killed vaccine where the virus is inactivated using heat, chemicals or irradiation, and this killed virus is then used in vaccine. Two doses of this vaccine need to be given 4 weeks apart. Covishield was developed by Oxford University in collaboration with British pharma company AstraZeneca. In India, this vaccine is being manufactured by Serum Institute of India, Pune. Covishield is a viral vector-based vaccine. It uses a modified harmless chimpanzee adenovirus to deliver the viral genetic code inside the human cells, which then instructs the human cell to produce antigen protein and display it on its surface. This in turn generates antibodies and immune response. To know more about how these vaccines work, click on the link below on right corner of your screen. Two doses of this vaccine are given 12 to 16 weeks apart to generate best immune response. Sputnik was developed by Gamaleya Research Institute of Microbiology and Epidemiology, Moscow, and is being distributed by Dr. Reddy's lab in India. Like Covishield, Sputnik is also viral vector based. The difference is that it uses two different types of modified harmless human adenovirus. For Sputnik, two doses are given 3 weeks apart. There is another vaccine in pipeline, Sputnik Lite, which requires just a single shot to protect against COVID. This vaccine is not yet licensed in India, but approval and launch procedures are ongoing. Next question arises regarding efficacy of these vaccines. The interim results of phase 3 studies of Covaxin suggest an efficacy of 81%. For Covishield, it is 76% and Sputnik 91%. We do not yet know how long would the vaccine remain effective. It is important to understand that there is no head-to-head comparison done between all these vaccines. So there is no best vaccine as such. All work well in preventing the infection as well as they prevent you from getting seriously ill. One question which we are frequently asked is regarding safety and side effects of these vaccines. Common side effects are fever, headache, muscle aches, pain and swelling at injection site. If you have any of these after vaccination, paracetamol can be safely taken for reducing these symptoms. Very rarely, very few people may develop severe allergic reactions to the vaccine, which usually happens within 15 to 30 minutes after getting the vaccine. Regarding blood clots reported with the use of Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, regulatory bodies in India have reported only 0.6 cases per million doses given. This risk is very, very small as compared to the benefits of getting the vaccine. One thing to remember, always contact your healthcare provider in case your symptoms last for more than 48 hours. Can I get COVID-19 from the vaccine? There have been concerns about COVID-19 vaccines making people sick with COVID, but none of these vaccines contain the live virus, which means they cannot make you sick with COVID. After vaccination, it usually takes a few weeks, around 2 weeks, for the body to build immunity against coronavirus. So, it is possible a person could be infected with COVID just before or after vaccination and still get sick with COVID-19. This is because the vaccine did not get enough time to provide protection. So, it's not the vaccine which causes severe diseases or deaths, but it's the ongoing pandemic which is making people sick. Can you get corona infection even after vaccination? Yes, you can, but you will mostly develop mild disease. Vaccines reduce the risk of serious illness and need for hospitalization and oxygen. Is there anyone who should not get vaccinated? Currently, according to Government of India guidelines, vaccine is not given to those less than 18 years, pregnant women, and those with history of severe allergic reactions. Other than this, there are certain conditions where it needs to be deferred but can be given. If you have recovered from COVID, you need to wait for 3 months for vaccine. In case you had a non-COVID serious illness requiring hospitalization, wait for 4 to 8 weeks after recovery. If you are a cancer patient and have undergone bone marrow transplantation, you need to wait for 3 months. If you have any immune system disorder needing immunoglobulin injections, vaccine can be given on a day other than your immunoglobulin infusion day, preferably after 2 weeks. Vaccines can be safely given in lactating women and in people with chronic diseases like diabetes, blood pressure, heart disease, and asthma. Will the vaccine work against virus variants? The COVID-19 vaccines are expected to provide at least some protection against new variants because these vaccines elicit a broad immune response involving many antibodies and cells. Preliminary results have been encouraging. A very recent study showed that Covaxin is protective against the double mutant virus currently circulating in India. Health regulatory bodies are continuously doing surveillance and collecting data on new variants of the COVID-19 virus, including their impact on the effectiveness of vaccines, if any. Will the vaccine change your DNA or cause infertility? No. These are all myths and they have no scientific basis at all. A very important question: what precautions you should take during and after vaccination? Wait at the vaccination center for at least 30 minutes after getting vaccinated to look for any immediate adverse reactions. Make sure you follow COVID appropriate behavior. Keep wearing mask, wash hands, maintain social distancing, and stay at home even after vaccination. In case of any health concerns after vaccination, contact your healthcare worker immediately. And lastly, about your kids. So far, the vaccines in India have not been approved for use in children. The good news is that Bharat Biotech has recently got a green flag to start trials in children 2 to 18 years of age. Once the trial results show safety and efficacy, they will be rolled out for use. Please click on the link below to find out more about vaccines and the new drug 2DG. Stay tuned to our channel to know more about various methods of giving vaccines on Thursday, 9:30 p.m. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy. Welcome back to